Hello, so today in this video I will discuss about the JavaScript objects. So JavaScript, first of all, you know already, in the JavaScript everything is in the objects, not in the class. So that's why the JavaScript is not a full-fledged object-oriented programming language. So it does not have a class. This point always keep in your mind, and it does not support many of the pattern which you expect from the object oriented language, for example inheritance and the polymorphisms. Okay, and this JavaScript only supports the objects. So I told three things. First things I told, this is not full-fledged object oriented programming language JavaScript. Here JavaScript does not have a class, and it does not support many of the patterns like object oriented programming language you have in the polymorphisms and inheritance. Such concepts are not there in the JavaScript, and it only supports the objects. Clear? In JavaScript, objects can have a constructors, properties and methods associated with them, and there are the objects that are included in the JavaScript language. You can also define your again the own kind of the object also in the JavaScript. Okay, so generally what is happening for the normally whenever creating the new object, you use the new keywords, right, in all of the programming languages. So here again the class name and the brackets we can use. Okay, so but here again we can write again the var, some object, new object name, and then again we can put the parameters, depends upon the n optional parameters you can put. But what in the JavaScript we can write like this also, var creating a shortcut way to constructors. We can write again the, suppose that I want to create the var greeting equal to good morning, but the formal way we can write the same statement, var greeting equal to new string, because the good morning is a string, na? So that's why the new string inside the again the parenthesis and the double quote bracket you put for the good morning, and the last of course we can put the semicolon only for termination of the statement. Whenever we are talking about the properties, so each object might have properties that can be accessed depending on its definitions. Clear? So when a property exists, it can be accessed using a dot notation, so where a dot between the instance name and the property reference that clear property reference that property only. So here again you can take example alert, inside the bracket you can put again the sum object dot property. So dot notation is the must to access the, again the property of that objects. When you are talking about the methods, so object can also have the methods which are function associated with that instance of an objects, and these methods are called using the same dot notations as for properties, but instead of the accessing the variables we are calling a method. So we can write like this one, some object dot do something, and then we can write the function bracket and semicolon. But here again methods may produce different output depending on the objects, and they are associated with because they can utilize the internal properties of the objects. So object include in the JavaScript, again the number of the objects are available in the JavaScript. One is called array, boolean, date, math, string and DOM objects. Okay, so these are the most popular again the objects which are available in the JavaScript. So first of all we are talking about the array. So array are the one of the most used data structures. In practice, this class is defined to behave more like a linked list, in that it can be resized dynamically. But the implementation is the browser specific, meaning the efficient of insert and delete operation is unknown. So these are the syntax, creates a new empty array name, you can see here again that we are creating the one empty array. Okay, and giving the array name here again the greetings. So how you can write, var space greetings equal to new keyword, then array, a is caps only. double r u y, and then you can put the function parenthesis bracket only open and close, and the finally the semicolon. So in this one's greetings is the empty array. Greetings is the empty array. So this is the syntax to create the array in JavaScript. So if you want to initialize the value inside the array, okay, so how you can do that once? So you can same way where previous example I told for the empty array. Now you can see here you can initialize the value inside the array, insert the value inside the array. So where greetings equal to new array, and suppose that you want to put the two value inside that array. So first value double quote good morning, close the double quote, comma, again the good afternoon double quote we have to put, then parenthesis bracket and just close it. So this is the one way. Same things if you want using the square bracket also you can do, where space greetings, that is the array, equal to a square bracket good morning and good afternoon inside the double quote, and separation bit from between these two we have to put the comma. So one more if you want to add, again comma double quote good evening, yeah, comma your name double quote we can put, but everything should be inside the square bracket. So this is the another way we can use the array in JavaScript along with the value, along with the value. Okay, so here double quote only indicate, double quote only indicate, sorry, a square bracket only indicate this greetings is the array types. Now whenever talking about the DOM, document object model, okay, JavaScript is almost always used to interact with the HTML document which it is contained, and this is a programming interface API. This is a programming interface which is called the document object model. So according to the W3C, what is the DOM? We can say here, as per the W3C, platform and language natural interface that will allow programs and scripts to dynamically access and update the content, structure and style of documents. This is the statement, this is according to the W3C meaning of the DOM. Platform and language natural interface that will allow programs and scripts to dynamically access and update the contents, structures and style of documents. Clear? So we already know about the DOM, but actually this I already discussed in the previous, I think whenever you're talking about the first module, that time I discussed. So here again the DOM tree is there in .trim, that is first one is called the document root. After the documents root we can go for the nodes, then the sibling nodes, and below of that sibling nodes again the child nodes. You see here again the document, then HTML. Under the HTML we have to write the two siblings, head and the body. Under the head we can write the meta tag and the title, you know already. Okay, then again the under the body h1 p img any html, again the child nodes you can write. Inside a division only you can write the paragraph, time, date and something. So that is again coming for the child nodes. So from the bottom to top you can see top one is called the parent nodes. Coming to the again the top to bottom, then we can say the below one is the child node. That is a common again the this one structures and the tree format for the DOM. That already we discussed in the HTML. So here again in the DOM, each element with the HTML document is called a node, right? And the DOM is a tree, then each node is an individual branch. So there are element nodes, text nodes and attribute nodes, and all nodes in the DOM share a common set of properties and methods. Clear? So here each node has an individual branch, and there are the three things. One thing is called element nodes, text nodes, attribute nodes, and all nodes in the DOM share a common set of properties and methods. So you see here example, inside the paragraph we are just photo of something pond, then one anchor tag is there, and along with the anchor tag again we display the message, because anchor tag means again we want to some statement to click now. So that is the central part. Okay, so you see here inside the paragraph is there, so p is again called the element node. Okay, along with the p, whatever the text you are displaying, that is called that photo of something pond is there, that is called a text node. Okay, another is again you already use inside the paragraph one more elements, HTML elements, that is called anchor tag. So that is called the element node. And again anchor tag, there are the two parts. One is again you put for the href. Href is the attributes of the anchor tag, so that is called the attribute nodes. Got it? Complete part. And along with that one we have to display the message now, so that is called the text node. So this is very simple example regarding the element node, text node, attributes nodes, right? So I think there is no confusion in this example to getting the again the all these three. So DOM nodes, again the certain properties are there. This is again important for your again the examination also. What is the attributes, collection of the nodes attributes, what is child nodes, and not list of the child nodes for this node, first child node of this node, last child of this node, next sibling, node name, node type, okay, node value, parent node, and previous sibling. Okay, so name itself only, after looking that tree structures only we can identify all of this object properties, DOM nodes object properties. Clear? Now in the document objects, in the document object is the root JavaScript object representing the entire HTML node, and it contains some properties and methods that we will use for our development, otherwise access if you want to access the some document value here then we can use. So one thing is there again the document dot doc type dot name, okay, another is the document dot input coding. So this is again for the specifying the doc type, first one. Second one, we can specify the page encoding, okay. So generally page encoding ISO 8859-1 is there, UTF-8 is there, so such kind of the encoding you can. Here document object, again the method when you were talking, so create attributes, one method is there, create attributes. So you see A is capital only, create element E is capital, create text node T capital, N capital, get element by ID. This is again one of the more popular document object method, create element by ID. E should be capital, B should be capital, and I should be capital, otherwise this method will not perform whenever you are using this method in the JavaScript. And get element by tag name, E capital, B capital, T capital, and name. So here whenever you want to create the attributes node, then you can use the create attributes. Creating element node, then you can use the create element. Create a text node, then use the create text node. But whenever you want to pass the value, you want to find process the value, not process, I can say the pass the value, then with the help of the ID name in the HTML you can pass this value, get element by ID. Same way get element by tag also we can pass the value. See example this ones, here again one division is there, red color you see, div id latest comments. So id of the division is the latest comment, so we can, if you want that value entire that division, whatever the values are there, if you want to pass that value, then you can write the document dot get element by id, okay, and then inside a double quote you can write that value, okay, semicolon, you can semicolon for termination purpose, after the bracket you can put, and after getting this value we have to store somewhere in the JavaScript now. So then again you utilize the variable's name abc, and that should be the var, just now I discussed now. So var abc equal to document dot get element by id, okay. So this way you can access the nodes value from the get element by id. Same way get element by tag also you can use. So whenever you are modifying a document element, DOM elements, so DOM document dot write method is used to create output to the HTML page from the JavaScript, and the modern JavaScript programming will want to write to the HTML page but in a particular location, not always at the bottom. Using the DOM document and HTML DOM element objects, we can do exactly that using the inner HTML properties. Okay, inner HTML properties. See example here. You want to just modify something if you want to change. So take example for the previous only, var latest equal to document dot get element by id. Okay, and then again the latest comments that we already passed the value, var old SMS message equal to latest dot inner HTML. So that all value you are again storing inside the old SMS, and then you want to add some value here, then we have to write the latest dot inner HTML equal to old message plus again the inside the paragraph tag whatever the message. So this value will be again the changing the inside that division all information, means the updated this div with the JS that message will display along inside that division. So inside the one division, inside the one again the any HTML again the tag, if you want to change the value, such kind of the this one in using the inner HTML we can do. Okay, so this is again modifying the, this is again the little bit again the more. So inner HTML techniques works well. There is a more technique available to the build the output using the DOM. One is again called the create text node, remove child, append child allows to modify the element in the more again the DOM elements. Okay, so here you see the first line already, you know, if I had less than getting the value, then inner HTML store the value, then new SMS, so you can replace this value. And if you want to remove the first child also, the latest dot remove child, latest dot first child. And if you want to add the one more child node again there, so latest dot append child we can put, create document dot create text node new message. So in that way you can add the remove the child, append the child and create the text node, anything so we can do. So regarding this one I will discuss in the next again the class, again the some more again the example, then it is good. This is the textbooks example. So otherwise you can open the w3school.com, there again the around the 5 to 6 good examples and simple examples are there. Using that one we'll get a better idea. Okay, so in this video I think you got the idea regarding the objects and the DOM in the JavaScript. So thanks for your patience.